At the time of the composition of Mulk Raj Anand's novel, Untouchable, the caste system had endured for over 2 millennia, stratifying society into 4 hierarchical tiers. At the apex resided the affluent, intellectuals, and wielders of authority. Contrarily, the untouchables occupied a subjugated position even beneath the lowest caste, regarded as unclean to the extent that their touch could contaminate higher caste members. In an early scene, Sohini ventures to the well to fetch water, an essential resource vital for survival and ideally accessible to all. The stark cruelty of the caste system manifests vividly in the line of untouchables waiting at the well, unable to step forward to draw water for themselves, regardless of their thirst. Dependent entirely on the benevolence of upper caste Hindus to fetch water on their behalf, this system, while severe, underscores the profound interdependence within the social fabric. The untouchables frequently endure derogatory epithets, with Bakha's father persistently reminding him of the inherent superiority of the Brahmins. To subsist, Bakha must resort to begging, enduring the indignity of food being hurled at him. Following Gandhi's discourse, Bakha overhears a poet remark, "Take a ploughman from the plough, wash off his dirt, and he is fit to rule a kingdom," is an old Indian proverb. The civility, comprehension, and gravity of the poorest of our peasants attest to this truth. Engage with a rural dweller and witness their kindness, their propensity for compliments, and their eloquence. The concept of human equality is no novel notion to them. Those in positions of power possess the means to effectuate change most readily. Yet, in Untouchable, it is the untouchables themselves, the victims of inequality, who grasp the profundity of its scourge upon society. Hence, Gandhi exhorts the untouchables to renounce acquiescence to inequitable treatment and demand the respect they are due. The novel's denouement leaves readers pondering the potential ramifications should all untouchables rise in defiance. Rejecting their mandated role as waste managers, soon to be replaced by mechanized flushing toilets. Religion serves as another thematic vehicle, highlighting the caste system's theological underpinnings within Hindu doctrine. Conceived as a divine decree, this system divides Hindus into 4 castes. The Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, and Shudras. Notably absent from the body of Brahma, the Hindu god whose physical attributes birth each caste, are the untouchables, forever relegated to their ordained station by the doctrine of predestination. Any aspiration beyond their status is deemed sinful for Bakha and his kin. Colonel Hutchinson, a Christian missionary, offers an alternative religious perspective purportedly more tolerant. He asserts that the Christian God is the God of all humanity, not merely of the white populace, an assertion that initially confounds Bakha yet intrigues him with the notion of a deity ostensibly concerned with universal equality. Paradoxically, this very God views all people as equally sinful and base, rendering the Christian faith untenable to Bakha. Religion further serves to critique outward appearances of righteousness versus actual deeds. When a man slaps Bakha, knocking off his turban in front of a mob, it is a Muslim, traditionally deemed as outcast as an untouchable in Hinduism, who defends and assists him in restoring his turban. Despite doctrinal opposition, the man's actions believably bridge the divide imposed by religious doctrine. Conversely, the temple priest, a Brahman of the highest order, assaults Sohini with the confidence of religious authority, illustrating the hypocrisy of piety in action. Generational oppression also looms large in the narrative. Late in the novel, Bakha's father, Lakha, reminds him, "You will toil for them your entire life, my son, after I am gone." Preceding the birth of his sons, Lakha himself labored as an untouchable. Across centuries, the caste system's cyclical grip endures, impressing upon Lakha the impracticality of nurturing aspirations loftier than street sweeping for Bakha. Children born into the untouchable class are indoctrinated early into their inferior status, ingrained in them as soon as they comprehend the hierarchical reality. The caste system, an ancient tradition reinforced by legal mandate in India until 1948, not only denies Bakha the chance to aspire to upper caste status but also forbids him from doing so under penalty of law. When the lawyer contemplates the daunting task, or, from his perspective, the futility of challenging entrenched traditions, his cynicism resonates with the historical inertia resistant to reforming deeply ingrained norms.